Police in Ottawa are still investigating what led to that city's worst ever mass killing. Five members of one family and an acquaintance all died Wednesday night.
Neighbors in the Barrhaven suburb left flowers and stuffed animals outside the home where the murders happened. The dead include a mother and her four children, as well as the family acquaintance. Police say the family from Sri Lanka was attacked with a knife-like edged weapon. The father was seriously injured. A 19-year-old international student living in the home, also from Sri Lanka, has been charged with the murders.
Global's Mackenzie Gray joins us from Ottawa tonight. And Mackenzie, Global News had an exclusive conversation with the aunt of the accused. What did she say?
Well, she was quite surprised, Alan, that this happened. Now, give a little backstory on the aunt's relationship with her nephew, 19-year-old Febrio De-Zoysa. He's, of course, now charged with 6 counts of first-degree murder and 1 count of attempted murder. He came to Canada about 2 years ago to study at Algonquin College. That's the largest college here in Ottawa. And that's where he met the father, the person that he attempted to kill, according to police, and the victim. He is, of course, the husband of the wife and the four children who died in this situation here. The aunt says, they met back at Algonquin College about 2 years ago while he was living with the aunt, but only for a short period of time did the accused live with the aunt. He moved out, was roommates with the father, the only survivor of this attack, and then the father actually invited the accused to move back in with him in Barrhaven about 2 months ago. That's when he moved in with his wife, four children, including a two-month-old who was murdered in this situation, and a family acquaintance. The aunt was very, very surprised that this happened, but she also did say, Alan, that about a year ago, the accused cut her out completely from their lives. So there was no communication over the last period of time. And the aunt, too, was very emotional when our colleague Jillian Piper was speaking with her, saying that she thought that this could have been her family and felt that the family that the accused was living with might have actually treated them even better than she did. So lots of very, very sad emotions, not only from the aunt feeling tons of guilt associated with this, but many people across the city today for one of the worst murders in Ottawa history.
It's so difficult to comprehend. And the Sri Lankan community speaking out as well about the father. What are they saying about his condition?
Yeah, we went down to the temple that they regularly attended and spoke with a number of people there, including one of the monks and one of the leaders within the temple. They actually had just come back from the hospital where they had said the father, the victim in this situation, had just had surgery for the day. He seemed to be in relatively good spirits and good condition, but there were substantial issues. His middle finger on one of his hands has been cut off. One of the other fingers he had been cut, but it seems like doctors were able to put that back on. There also seemed to be fairly large cuts, judging by what friends told Global News, that there were large cuts on his face, back, ears, and potentially an issue with his eye as well. So some serious injuries, potentially lifelong issues that this father could be facing. But despite all that, one of the folks that we talked to said the father wanted to make it clear that there should be a compassionate view taken to the accused in this situation, saying that he's just a young man, that he is early in his life. And it certainly seems, Alan, like quite a stance to take in this situation after your family has been killed, allegedly killed by this young man that you invited into your own home. You're in hospital with serious injuries, yet you decide to view and make it clear to the public that a compassionate view should be taken on this individual, quite an individual who's in hospital right now. Police said yesterday that he's in stable condition, and friends said to us today too, Alan, that he should be able to get out of hospital soon. Hopefully he'll be doing okay, but the emotional issues of losing his entire family is something he'll carry with him for the rest of his life.
Yeah, obviously. Thank you so much, Mackenzie. Appreciate that.